Assalamu alaikum dear student, welcome back to the part 2 of the chapter 1 of the course, breeding policy. Okay, objectives of the, as according to the breeding policy document of the government of the Punjab, the objective of the dairy and buffalo breeding is to improve the milk production, reduction in the age of the maturity. That is more, you can say, controlled by the environment than the genetics. However, the milk production is mainly controlled by the genetics, or it have substantial control by the genetics, you can say. Improving of the reproductive efficiency, again this is something to do with the management practices, but still we have some genetic control. Improvement in the quality and quantity of the beef produced, these are the objective of the dairy policy of the Punjab. Here I would like to let you know that the other provinces, they are in the process of the development of the breeding policy, and I have been the part of this exercise, especially in the KPK, I guess it was last year, if I do remember exactly, but the currently only we are available with the Punjab breeding policy. Whereas the crossbreeding of the purebred cattle such as Sahiwal and Red Sindhi with the exotic semen, this is not allowed. And here I would like to let you know that we have also a breeding act in the province of the Punjab, and this also does not allow you to crossbreed the pure Sahiwal or Red Sindhi cattle to the cross versus semen. In case of buffalo, we are lucky enough that we do have the best buffalo in the world. So there is no question of crossbreeding, but in case of Sahiwal, Red Sindhi, this issue is there. Other than Red Sindhi, Cholisani is also prone to the crossbreeding. But as per the policy document, one cannot do it. According to the Act, one cannot do it. And for in Punjab province, there is Livestock Breeding Services Authority to monitor all this stuff. So to what extent they are monitoring, this is another question. Similar authority is established in the Sindh province. And I visited that authority this year, and we are having some conversation with them to have collaboration at national level. But at the moment, there are only two authorities in the country. So another important thing which I want to share with you, because this is very important to know us, that after the 18th Amendment in the Constitution of the Pakistan, the livestock is the provincial subject. So that's why the authorities are limited to the provinces, and they are taking care of all this stuff. So non-descript cattle, crossbreeding for the non-descript cattle is allowed. And I believe as a geneticist, if we do that in a very well controlled and very well organized manner, we can have something out of these non-descript animals which are not to the at mark as far as milk production is concerned. So there are two, you can say, the improvement programs, one for Sahiwal, one for the Nili Ravi, and that is progeny testing program. They are going through, right now in the Punjab province. And the National Center is also working closely with these stakeholders to improve the livestock population, particularly the Sahiwal and Nili Ravi buffalo. However, we don't have any conservation policy for the small ruminants or the equines or the poultry or any other species. So I would like to quote my own book. I mentioned in the previous lecture. If you go through that book, there are a couple of new breeds in goat which we observed first time, have never ever been reported. But there is also depletion, or there is also extinction of the known breeds. So the dynamics of the breed development is changing over the period of time. And for all species livestock, we do need to have some research to establish which type of breed do we have, and what are the marking utilities, and how we can improve them. So progeny testing program, I mentioned that it will, with the help of the bull mother scheme or with other names it is currently going on, and it was started in late 80s in the country, and still it is going on. The issue with these programs are that they do not have the continuous you can say support from the government in terms of the funds. Then the small holding, this is another issue. And for all these we do need a thoughtful policy, and need certain intervention with the existing policy to improve the genetic resources for dairy purpose. Crossbreeding with the exotic semen of the non-descript is allowed. So there have been certain exercises, for example, Nari Master in Baluchistan to develop a beef breed. But we do not have any, you can say, these exercises have been there, Bahadur Nagar farm in Punjab province, there some exercises have been, had been carried on in the future. But today we don't have any recognized beef breed in the country. In my point of view, maybe we don't need that. Reason being, we have a huge number of the population in, and that those animals which we don't use for breeding purpose, we can go for fattening and we can use as a beef animal. So I was talking about the Nari Master. So that was built, or that was exercise have been carried out to develop this breed with the name of the Nari Master, where 62.5% in intelligence from Australian Drought Master and 37.5% from the local Bhagnari cattle. But as we don't have enough number of that population to be declared as population, so we can say we don't have beef breed. Some other species, for example, Kagani sheep with the rambolet, that has been exercised in the KPK province. Similarly, using these chicken breeds, LSB, livestock silver, there was the Lalpur silver breed that was developed for the chicken, especially for the egg production, but to date we don't have its enough number again. There are certain incentives that have been provided by the government from time to time. National laws prohibit slaughter for useful animals, and then 2 meatless days. This was started in the era of the 60s, but still to date these are the part of the rules and regulations, and the purpose of that was to avoid the depletion of the small ruminants. Then reduce imported duties have been exercises by the government from time to time to encourage the improvement of the local livestock, duty free improve of the breeding stock, especially in case of the chicken. This has been carried out extensively, and that's the reason that today we have a very well established poultry industry. Milk processing plants, these have been exercised through different programs, especially in Punjab province. And during that time, the big processor companies such as Nestle, they emerged from these all programs. Institutional sports have been there, animal health services and breeding through the livestock and dairy development programs. As I mentioned to that, Saival and Nili Ravi genetic program is being carried out. And the vaccination is provided by the livestock departments, then the veterinary medicines. Livestock farms are there, these farms at least have done their role to preserve the local breeds, then the artificial services. Now, what's the coverage of the artificial insemination? This is another chapter, this is another story. To date, what we have been communicated, it's not more than 10% in the cattle, and in buffalo, it's even lesser than that. So this is the area we need to give the institutional sports to enhance the coverage. Then the Idara Kisan, just I mentioned its purpose was to collect the milk and the process. That's why the GTZ program, with the help of the German government, then IFAD for smallholder dairy development project, then the livestock development projects, ADB through Agriculture Development Bank, Integrated Range and Livestock Development Project. So these different projects have been running, and the funding has been there, but the core issue in my opinion was the sustainability of these programs. So once the donors they stop funding, then everything collapses. This is the very serious thing. Thank you very much. So please go through these lectures and these presentations as well as the material provided to you, and you can float your questions as well. Thank you very much.